What we've seen so far is that the principle of relativity says that physics is the same in all inertial frames. That is, moving with a constant velocity. An observer can't detect absolute motion, only motion relative to something else. In the 19th century, physicists wondered whether there was some universal frame of reference that everything would be referred to. And their investigations into light gave some hints about that. The Scottish physicist James Clerk Maxwell in 1864 published a set of equations which showed how electric and magnetic fields are interrelated. Those equations predicted that there would be oscillations of these electric and magnetic fields which would give rise to electromagnetic waves. And from his equations he calculated the velocity of these waves and calculated they would travel at 300,000 kilometers per second. Now that turned out to be exactly the measured speed of light, which is a good indication that light is in fact an electromagnetic wave. So if light is a wave of oscillating electric and magnetic fields, what medium does it travel in? We know that sound waves travel in air, water waves travel in water. What do light waves travel in? Well, the physicist said, let's just call it the luminiferous ether. Now, light travels everywhere, even in empty space. So the ether, if it exists, must be present everywhere too. So maybe it can provide this universal reference frame that everyone was seeking. But in 1887, Michelson-Morley performed a famous experiment which attempted to measure the movement of the Earth through the ether. But no matter how carefully they did their experiment, they weren't able to detect any motion. The apparatus they used, I've got a model of that here, and it consisted of a light source at the bottom here, shining up towards this half-silvered mirror. Half of the light went off across the red arm to this mirror here, where it reflected back. Half went straight up the blue arm to this mirror here, where it reflected back. And then from the half-silvered mirror, they both reflected back to the detector here, where they were observed. Now, of course, the length of these two arms might be slightly different. So when they recombine, the light waves wouldn't quite be in phase. And if the peak of one coincides with the trough of another, they would cancel out and you get darkness. But if the peaks added together, they would sum up and you get bright. So if you look through the telescope, you might expect to see bright and dark fringes. Now, of course, if the whole of the Earth is moving through the ether like that, the light is going this way, is going downstream and upstream again in the ether, but the one going this way is going across the ether stream. So if you rotate the apparatus, then the one that was going up and down becomes across, and the one that was going across becomes up and down. So you would expect the fringes to change. Michelson-Morley put the whole of their apparatus on floated on a bath of mercury so it could rotate very smoothly, and they observed the fringes while they did it, but the fringes never changed at all, indicating that they were unable to detect movement through the ether. Now, in 1894, Lorentz and Fitzgerald independently suggested an explanation of this result. They said that if this arm, which was moving along through the ether, contracted, then it would account for the fact that there was a null result from the Michelson-Morley experiment. And they calculated exactly how much you would need to contract to explain the fact that the fringes didn't move. But they had no explanation of why that should occur. So let's just see what Einstein's problem is at this point. He knew that Newton's laws of motion said the force is mass times acceleration, which implies if you accelerate a body with constant force, it gets faster and faster as much as you like. You can accelerate it up to any speed. Therefore, you would in principle travel at the speed of light. But then a light wave would appear stationary. And Maxwell's equations say that light always travels at the same speed. So a stationary light wave just can't exist. So Newton and Maxwell can't both be right. One of them must be wrong. The other problem is that light waves are supposed to travel in the ether, but the Michelson-Morley experiment was unable to detect the movement of the Earth through the ether. So the ether can't provide this absolute frame of reference that everyone was looking for, and therefore motion is always relative. So this led to the solution that Einstein was looking for in his paper on the special theory of relativity. It was published in June 1905, and his title, rather boringly, was On the Electrodynamics of, Moving Bodies. This is an English translation of the paper. I suppose the most surprising thing about the paper is that it didn't really include any references to any previous work. It just started off with a few basic assumptions, and from that, by logical deduction, produced some rather surprising results.